Just like we use aux sends to feed monitors and effects, we use both groups and the main left-right mix, which is also just called the mains or the master bus, to feed the main speaker system. First, in this video, we look at the main left-right mix, which feeds the main speaker system. Then we talk about groups, which have flexible routing, and we discuss how using EQ on your outputs gives you control of the overall tone of your mix. When we're mixing front of house, meaning the sound for the main speaker system, we need to create a good balance so the audience can hear everything on stage. Now, once the signals hit the console, we make adjustments to the gain and on the channel strips and keep a balanced mix on the faders. Then we could send the signal directly to the main mix and onto the speakers, but there are other routing options on most consoles. For example, we can route channels to a group. This sends the selected channels to a subgroup, which can then be sent onto the main mix, or routed somewhere else completely, like a separate physical output of the console. We do need to remember, though, that each fader along the way is part of the signal chain and needs to be assigned correctly. So if we assign the channel to groups 1 and 2, we would then need to assign groups 1 and 2 to left-right, and the channel fader must be up as well as the group faders for the signal to reach the main outputs. We usually assign channels to groups in the same place we assign them to the main mix. On digital consoles, this is done in the software, and on analog consoles, it is usually done near the fader. But analog consoles often have the groups in stereo pairs like this, and the pan knob can be used to send signal to the odd or the even group. Large format analog consoles could have 8 or even 16 groups, and we could, for example, assign a channel directly to one group, then assign that to both channels of the main mix. Or the signal could be sent through the group and also be assigned to the left-right on the channel. This is called double busing and will actually increase the level of that channel in the mix. Nothing is necessarily wrong with doing this, just make sure you're aware of everywhere it's being routed. So as far as using groups, what we commonly do is have a set of mics, like all the vocal mics, assigned to a group, and then that group can be used to turn all those mics up or down in a mix. Or that group could be EQ'd or compressed, or even sent to a separate output of the console to feed things like additional speakers. However, we definitely don't have to use groups, and I quite often just assign my input channels directly to the main left-right mix, which then feeds the speaker system. This keeps it simple, which is quite often the best way to go in live sound. Once we have our mixes built and sent to outputs, we can insert EQs on those outputs to control the overall tone of any mix. This could be an overall EQ for the main speakers, or an EQ for each of the monitor mixes. Many people use graphic EQ on their monitor sends to help quickly eliminate feedback, and I personally always use parametric EQ for my front of house mixes. But either way, using EQ on each output can add up pretty quickly. And since analog consoles don't have this stuff built in, they need racks full of outboard gear, including all the gates and compressors for the inputs. Of course, digital consoles have all this stuff built in, and we talk about more of these differences later on. In this video, we looked at the main left-right mix, then we saw how groups have flexible routing, and we discussed inserting EQs on outputs.